please remain standing and raise your right hand. Do you swear that the testimony that you're going to provide this jury will be the truth and nothing but the truth, so help you God?
I do.
Kayla, can you begin by stating and spelling your full name for the record?
My name is Kayla Montgomery, K-A-Y-L-A, M-O-N-T-G-O-M-E-R-Y.
And how old are you, Kayla?
33.
Where do you currently live?
I am in the correctional facility for women's in Concord, New Hampshire.
How long have you been there?
For over a year.
Kayla, why are you currently incarcerated?
For perjury, for lying on to the jury about the whereabouts of where I was and where Harmony was.
And when you say lying to the jury, was that the grand jury?
Yes.
Did you also lie to the police?
Yes.
Why'd you do that?
Because I was scared, and I was told by Adam to stick with that story that I got dropped off at work at Dunkin' Donuts, where I no longer worked at that time, and to say that he was bringing Harmony to meet her mother, Crystal, and that he dropped her off with her. And then when he came and picked me up from work, which I was not working there at the time, he didn't have her in the car, which that was a lie.
That story that you just told, that was what you told the grand jury?
Yes.
It's what you told the police?
Yes.
And was that in fact what happened?
No.
You said you've been sentenced for lying.
Yes.
You're living at the prison. Do you understand the consequences of providing false testimony?
Yes.
And since those lies, since your time in prison, have you sat down with investigators? Have you sat down with the Attorney General's office and provided additional statements?
Yes.
How many times?
About 4 times.
How many hours?
A couple hours at a time when they've came to see me, or I've gone out to the office to meet with them.
Did you reach a plea agreement with the state?
Yes.
And that was on the perjury charges?
Yes.
Other charges were dismissed, is that right?
Yes.
The story that you just told about the defendant dropping Harmony off with Crystal, who came up with that story?
Adam.
Why did you stick to it?
Because I was scared for myself and my children that are also Adam's, and for him, because I didn't want anybody to get in trouble and I was scared.
Your Honor, may I approach?
Yes.
Kayla, you referred to Harmony Montgomery just now. How do you know her?
She's Adam's daughter, and he started a year after we got together. He was working on getting custody of her, and he had to work to get custody of her. He wasn't just given her. And it took 4 years to get custody of her. And during those 4 years, we both visited her each week for a couple hours.
Was she your stepdaughter?
Yes.
Showing this witness what's been previously marked as State's Exhibit 98 for identification. Do you recognize this?
Yes.
Who's depicted in this image?
Harmony and myself.
And can you point to Harmony? And is there a date associated with this image?
Yes, July 7th, 2019.
And do you recognize this image?
Yes.
Is it a fair and accurate representation of Harmony on that day?
Yes.
Who's the other person depicted in that picture with Harmony?
Myself.
Is that a fair and accurate representation of you that day?
Yeah.
Do you know who took this photo?
I did.
Your Honor, at this point I'd move to admit, to strike the ID and mark as full, State's Exhibit 98.
Any objection?
No objection.
And publish.
The ID is stricken, it's entered as a full exhibit, and it may be published to the jury.
Ayla, what were you and Harmony doing in this photograph?
We were taking pictures and laughing, playing. We always did silly pictures.
You mentioned getting custody of Harmony at some point. Do you remember when that was?
It was the month of February of 2019.
And where were you living when you got custody of Harmony?
77 Guilford Street in Manchester, New Hampshire.
When you got custody of Harmony, was she potty trained?
Yes.
Was she potty trained after you got her or before you got her?
Before.
Did she have accidents when you first got her?
No.
So you mentioned 77 Guilford Street. When did you move into that home?
It was in 2018, probably around April or May, I think. It was around that time.
Whose home was it?
Adam's grandmother's, Helen Montgomery.
Did she live there with you at any point?
Yes, when we were staying there in the beginning, she lived there.
And in the beginning, who else lived there with you?
Adam's uncle, Kevin Montgomery, Adam's brother, Michael Montgomery, and Adam's brother's girlfriend, Kayla. I don't remember her last name.
Another Kayla, though.
Yeah. And myself and Adam, and we had Seamus.
How old was Seamus when he moved into that house?
About to turn one.
Would you recognize that Guilford Street house if you saw it today?
Yes.
Your Honor, may I approach you?
Yes.
Kayla, I'm handing you what's been previously marked as State's Exhibits 1 and 2. Can you look at those for me, please?
That's the house. And this was Harmony's room.
And do you recognize the items that are depicted in those exhibits?
Yes.
Are they fair and accurate representations of what's contained in those exhibits?
Yes.
Your Honor, I move to strike the ID and mark as full, State's Exhibit 1 and 2.
They're already full?
I think they are already full. I think they're already full.
Yeah. I move to publish, Your Honor.
Yes, you may.
Kayla, State's Exhibit 2, what can you tell us about this room?
Adam and I helped decorate this room right before Harmony came to live at Guilford Street. And She really likes Minnie Mouse.
When you say she really liked Minnie Mouse, who is she?
Harmony.
When you say you helped decorate the room, what did you do to decorate it?
Got the Minnie Mouse wall decor that stick to the wall, and got her a whole new bed set, blankets and sheets.
There's no bed in that photo, but was Harmony's bed in that room?
Yes.
Where would it have been located in relation to that image?
Right next to the window.
And Kayla, whose room was that prior to Harmony moving in?
It was Helen Montgomery's room.
Kayla, I'm showing you it's been marked as State's Exhibit 10 for identification. Do you recognize this?
Yeah, it was Harmony's toothbrush.
Is it a fair and accurate representation of Harmony's toothbrush?
Yes.
Your Honor, I move to strike the ID and mark as full State's Exhibit 10.
Any objection?
No objection.
The ID is stricken. It's entered as a full exhibit. It may be published.
Kayla, you mentioned that Helen moved out and Harmony took over her room.
Yes, she moved out of the room, but she was still living at the house.
Did she eventually leave the house?
Yes.
When was that?
In May of 2019.
Do you know where she went?
Florida.
Kayla, I want to turn your attention to July of 2019, so several months after Helen moved out. Were you still living in the Guilford Street home in July of 2019?
Yes.
And who was living there with you at that point?
It was myself and Adam and his uncle Kevin. And it was Seamus and our son Declan and Harmony and his brother Michael and his girlfriend Kayla were still living there for a couple weeks until they moved out and went to Florida with her.
You mentioned this earlier, but where were you working at that point in your life?
I was working at Dunkin' Donuts.
Were you eventually terminated from your work at Dunkin' Donuts?
Yes.
Why?
Because I was stealing money from the register.
Did you admit to stealing money?
Yes.
Did you actually write a letter acknowledging that you had stolen?
Yes.
Did you take responsibility for what you'd done at Dunkin'?
Yes.
You mentioned that in July of 2019, Kevin Montgomery was still living in the Guilford Street home.
Yes.
Did he eventually leave for Florida after Helen?
I don't remember where he went. I remember Helen had surgery. She had open triple bypass surgery. And I don't remember if Kevin went to Florida. And I think he went to Mass, too. I don't remember where he went.
Let me ask you this. Do you remember him being gone from the house for several weeks?
Yes.
And let's talk about that period where Kevin's gone from the house, okay? You were still working at that point?
Yes.
What were your hours like at work?
I worked 6 a.m. to 2 p.m. And I also covered shifts if they needed help.
The three children that you mentioned?
Yes.
Where were they when you were at work?
With Adam.
And so in July of 2019, your youngest, Declan, how old would he have been?
He was about 6 months old.
And you said you were working from 6 a.m. to 2 p.m.?
Yes.
Did you like that setup?
Yes.
When you'd get home from work at 2 p.m., what would you do? What would your day look like?
I would come back home and help take care of the kids and feed them regularly, get them ready for bed later. We'd watch movies or they'd be playing.
You mentioned Kevin Montgomery leaving for some period.
Yes.
Did he return to the home at some point?
Yes, he showed up with Helen.
So before that, though, in July of 2019, did he return to the home at some point?
I don't remember.
Do you remember overhearing a conversation between Kevin and the defendant, Adam?
Yes.
What was the tone of that conversation?
They were arguing about a situation that happened with Harmony.
What was Kevin's tone in that argument? How did he sound?
He sounded angry.
What did Kevin say in that conversation? May we approach?
Yes.
Kayla, you mentioned Kevin sounded angry.
Yes.
Was this a quiet conversation?
No.
How would you describe it?
Yelling at each other back and forth. Argumentative. Yeah, it was just loud and angry.
Where were you during this conversation?
In the living room of the house in Guilford Street.
And where were the children?
Playing.
Did you understand what they were talking about?
Yes. I know that they were arguing about a black eye that Harmony had, that I was told that...
So, the black eye that Harmony had. Had you seen that before that argument?
Yes.
And tell this jury where you saw that black eye.
On the side.
First time you saw it.
It was on the side of her face right here. It was really red. It didn't really turn black and blue until like the next day.
So the first day you saw it, when it was red, really red, how did you see that? Where were you?
I came home from work, and I saw her face, and it was red, and I was told that...
And let me stop you there. You came home from work.
Yeah.
So this would have been around 2 p.m.?
Yeah.
Did you have an understanding of where Harmony had been that day?
Yes.
And tell us where that was.
She was at home at Guilford Street.
Who was she at home with?
With Adam and Uncle Kevin and Seamus and Declan.
And when you got home, when you saw this injury, the redness to Harmony's eye, did you ask the defendant what happened to her?
Yes.
What did he tell you?
That her and Seamus were playing and Seamus hit her in the face with the lightsaber by accident.
After you heard that confrontation between the defendant and Kevin, did you confront the defendant?
Yes, I asked him.
And at that point, did he tell you a new story about this injury to Harmony's eye?
No, it was the same. Well, yeah, he ended up telling me after.
What was the new story he told you?
That he ended up hitting her in the face because she covered our son's mouth because he was crying and he was in the bathroom. He went to the bathroom. Declan was crying and Harmony had her hand over his mouth. And he came out of the bathroom and saw that, and his lips were blue, or purple blue, and he hit her.
Did he describe how he hit her?
He smacked her in the face.
Did he acknowledge causing that injury to her?
Yes.
Do you know a Demetrius Soros with DCYF?
Yes.
Did he come to the house after that interaction between Kevin and the defendant?
Yes.
Did you know at the time what the purpose of his visit was?
Yes.
What was it?
DCYF got called about the children not being taken care of and that Adam was abusing his daughter.
When Mr. Soros arrived at your home, what did the defendant do with Harmony?
He left with her. He grabbed Harmony and left with her.
He grabbed her and left?
Yeah.
Did you have a conversation with Demetrios that day?
Yes.
In that conversation, did you cover for the defendant?
Yes.
Why?
Because I didn't want him to get in trouble.
Was there a period in 2019 when you no longer lived at the house on Guilford Street?
Yes.
And tell us how that came to be.
We ended up getting evicted from the house in November of 2019, the day before Thanksgiving, because the mortgage wasn't being paid.
And Your Honor, may we approach?
Yes.
Thank you. Your Honor, I'd ask that the court take judicial notice that the day before Thanksgiving in 2019 was November 27th.
The court takes judicial notice that the day before Thanksgiving in 2019 was November 27th, 2019.
Kayla, why were you evicted from the home?
Because the mortgage wasn't getting paid.
And after you were evicted, where did you begin living?
In our car.
What kind of vehicle was it?
A Chrysler Sebring.
When you began living in that car, who were you with?
It was myself and Adam, Harmony, and the two boys.
Where were you sleeping during that period?
In the car.
Where would you keep the car?
Behind Colonial Village in Manchester.
Why Colonial Village?
Because that's where our friend lived.
What was your friend's name?
Anthony Bodero.
Did you tell Mr. Bodero that you were living there in that parking lot?
He asked us not to, but yes.
And so, can you just describe the sleeping arrangement in that vehicle for you and your family at the time?
So, Adam would sleep in the driver's seat. I slept in the passenger seat, and Harmony was behind the passenger seat, and the baby, Declan, was in the middle, and Seamus was behind the driver's seat.
Kayla, I asked you earlier about whether Harmony was potty trained when you got custody of her, and I believe you said she was.
Yes.
Did that change at some point after the eviction?
Yes.
And tell the jury about that. What happened to Harmony?
She wouldn't let us know when she had to use the bathroom, and so she was peeing in the car, just in her seat that she was sitting in, and she wouldn't tell us that she had to use the bathroom.
Was she only peeing, or was she having other accidents at the time?
She was also pooping.
How frequently was this occurring for Harmony?
A lot, like at least every day.
And did those accidents, did they increase in frequency the longer you were in that car?
Yes.
How was the defendant responding when she had these accidents?
Getting angry.
Would he do anything physically to her when she had accidents?
Yeah, he would smack her.
And what does that mean that he would smack her?
He would smack her in the face, or on her leg, or in her hand.
Were these soft smacks,
no.
Hard smacks, or something else?
They were, like, hurt, stung smacks.
What makes you say hurt, stung smacks?
Because she would cry during, like, whenever she got smacked by him, and I could hear it, and it sounds like it hurt.
I'm sorry, you could hear the crying or you could hear the smack?
Smack and the crying.
When you say she was crying, who's she?
Harmony.
Those strikes, were they manifesting in any way on Harmony?
Yes.
How were they manifesting on her?
The more accidents she had, the more he would get angry, and he would hit her repetitively.
Was the defendant causing visible injuries to Harmony?
Yes.
I'm sorry?
Yes.
And tell us about those injuries.
When he would hit her, she started getting black eyes, and bruises on her face, on her legs.
Did you ever see her bleed as a result of being struck by him?
No, I didn't see that.
Did you ever see the defendant attempt to cover Harmony?
Yes.
And can you tell the jurors how he did that?
He would cover her with a comforter that we had in the car.
Why would he cover her?
So nobody could see her.
How often would he cover Harmony?
All the time. Anytime that we had interference with anybody, no matter who it was.
Was this only when you went out in public, or was it when you were still in that parking lot, or both?
Both.
Kayla, were you involved in a car accident on November 29th of 2019?
Yes.
And I want to turn your attention to that day. Who were you with that day?
Tabitha Scott.
Who else was in the vehicle during that accident?
Adam, myself, Harmony, and the two boys.
Who was driving?
Adam.
That Sebring, did you regularly drive it? Did you drive it at all?
Yeah, I didn't drive it, but he did. He had the license, I did not.
You didn't have a license at the time?
No.
So you said that Adam was driving, the defendant was driving the vehicle. Where were you in position to the rest of the people in the vehicle?
I was sitting with Harmony in the back seat behind the passenger side.
And where was Harmony?
Next to me in Declan. She was in between.
And where was Seamus?
In his car seat on the other side of Declan.
Would that have been behind the driver's seat?
Yes.
You mentioned the Tabitha Scott.
Yes.
Who is she to you?
She's been one of my friends for a long time.
And she was in the car with you that day?
Yes.
Where was she seated?
In the passenger seat.
And what was Tabitha Scott doing with you that day?
We were going to get drugs.
And can you just walk us through the accident, how it occurred?
There was a stop sign, and it was an intersection. There was a stop sign. It was a four-way intersection, and there was a truck that went through their stop sign, and we already had stopped, so we were going and ended up hitting that car, the truck.
Did law enforcement respond to that accident?
Yes.
Did you see an officer?
Yes.
Were the officers able to see Harmony?
No.
Tell the jurors why not.
Adam didn't want the officers to see her because she had black eyes. So she was covered with a blanket.
Were there other people, specific individuals, that he would cover Harmony up and keep her hidden from?
Yes.
And tell us who those individuals were.
It was Anthony Madero. And when Tabby was in the car, she didn't see her, but she knew she was in the car.
Kayla, so this accident occurred on November 29th.
Yes.
I want to turn your attention to December 7th of 2019.
Yeah.
Does that day stand out to you?
Yes.
Why?
It's the day that Harmony passed away.
The day that Harmony passed away?
Yeah.
Were you still living in the car at that point?
Yes.
Were you still sleeping in the Colonial Village parking lot?
Yes.
You mentioned Harmony having accidents and then becoming more frequent at that point. On December 7th, was she still having those accidents?
Yes.
And had they increased in frequency?
Yes.
Did Harmony have an accident first thing in the morning?
Yes.
And that would have been before you started your day?
Yes.
What happened when she had that accident?
Adam repetitively kept punching her in the head.
So I want to break that up. That morning, where did you wake up?
At Colonial Village.
And what happened first thing in the morning that morning?
We went to the methadone clinic.
And before you left for the methadone clinic, did Harmony have an accident?
Yes.
And what did the defendant do before you went to the methadone clinic? What did the defendant do to Harmony after that accident?
He was yelling and screaming at her and punching her in the head.
How did she react to that?
She was crying.
You mentioned the methadone clinic. Was that Habit Opco?
Yes.
And what did you do at the methadone clinic that morning?
Got my dose of methadone, and Adam got his also.
And do you remember who went in first?
No, I don't remember who went first.
Your Honor, may I approach?
Yes.
I'm handing you what's been marked for identification as State's Exhibit 89.
Okay.
I'm just going to ask that you review the second page. And this page, paying careful attention to the times. The item I just handed you, what is that?
Our dose history from our the clinic.
And that's Habit Opco?
Yes.
And having looked at those records, do you recall who went into the clinic first that morning?
Yes, I did.
What time was that at?
7:04 in the morning.
And what time did the defendant go in?
It was 7:09 in the morning.
Your Honor, at this time I moved to strike ID of State's Exhibit 89 and Marcus Full.
Any objection? Okay.
The ID is stricken and centered as a full exhibit.
Can you tell the jurors what happened when Adam returned to the vehicle after his methadone treatment?
When Adam came back to the vehicle, he could smell urine, and he started yelling at Harmony and kept hitting her in the head repetitively.
Where were you when he smelt that accident? Where was the vehicle when you smelled that accident?
In front of the methadone clinic.
Did you discuss going somewhere with him at any point that morning? Going to get food?
Yes. I asked to go to Burger King.
You asked to go to Burger King?
Yes.
And so at some point, did he begin driving the vehicle?
Yes.
Was that before or after he repeatedly struck Harmony?
After.
What was Harmony doing at that point when he started driving the vehicle?
She was crying a lot.
She was crying a lot?
Yeah. And she was making a weird noise.
Was she saying anything?
No.
And Kayla, I want you to walk the jurors through in as much detail as you can what happened on your route from Habit Opco to that Burger King.
Adam was getting really angry from Harmony peeing in the car, and he repetitively kept punching her on the way to Burger King, and there were a couple red lights, and when we were at red lights, he would go over the driver's seat, like in between the passenger seat, and he was just punching her repetitively in the head.
And you've said there were several times where he punched her repetitively in the head.
Yes.
How many times did he hit her?
I can't count. I don't know.
Were you counting?
No, I wasn't.
How many lights did that car come to where he repetitively struck her?
At least two or three.
Between Habit Opco and the Burger King, did the defendant say anything to Harmony?
I told her to shut the fuck up. Stop crying.
You said she was making a weird noise.
Yes.
Can you describe it?
It was like I can't even describe it. It was like a moaning kind of noise, but crying. It was just weird. I can't explain it.
Did you try to help Harmony while he was striking her?
Yes.
Tell the jurors what you did to help, to try to help.
I put my arm up and said to stop, but he looks at me and he gave me this look that was like evil. His crazy eyes. I didn't like it. And I couldn't stop him from hitting her. Because the look that he gave me was scary. I was scared.
What were you feeling when he looked at you like that?
Like he was either gonna hit me or just, I don't know. It was weird. And that was like one of the first times that I've seen him look at me like that.
Was it the last time you saw him look at you like that?
No.
And we'll talk about that more. But I want to focus on this drive. You said that Harmony's crying. She's making this weird noise.
Yeah.
Where was she in the vehicle?
She was behind the passenger seat.
And who was in front of her in that car?
I was.
You described the defendant almost coming over the seat.
Yes.
Was he still driving at that point?
Some, like, kind of. Like, between the red lights and... It was definitely at the red lights. I remember that.
How was he striking her?
By punching her in the head.
Where were your other two children at that time?
In the back seat.
And what were they doing?
They had no idea what was going on.
How old were they?
Seamus was
about 2 and a half, and Declan was 11 months old.
Did you look back at Harmony at any point?
No.
Why not?
Because I was scared.
What were you scared of?
If Adam was going to say something, or if he hurt her really bad, it was going to look really bad.
You were scared of what Harmony would look like? That attempt to intervene, were you successful in that?
No.
Did he stop after that?
Shortly after that.
Shortly after that. Did he say anything to you when he stopped?
He said he thinks that he really hurt her. And he felt something.
When he said that he thinks he really hurt her, where was the vehicle at that point?
At Burger King.
At the Burger King?
Yes.
And what did the defendant do after he stopped hitting Harmony, after he said, I think I really hurt her?
Nothing.
Did you order food from Burger King?
Yes.
Where was Adam when you were ordering food from Burger King?
In the driver's seat.
Did you go inside to the Burger King or something else?
No, I don't remember going in there.
Did you go through the drive-thru?
Yes.
And so who ordered the food?
Adam did.
And what did you do with the food that he had ordered?
Ate it, gave some to the kids.
Where were you when you ate the food?
In the parking lot.
Which parking lot?
Of Burger King.
Now, the kids were behind you at that point.
Yes.
Is that what you testified to?
Yes.
And who gave them food?
I did.
Did you see Harmony when you were giving them food?
No.
Why not?
Because she was under the blanket.
Who put her under the blanket?
Adam.
That's the same blanket that you mentioned earlier.
Yes.
The same blanket he would cover her with?
Yes.
Where did you go from the Burger King parking lot, Kayla?
Went back to Colonial Village.
And how did you get there?
With the vehicle, Adam driving.
Was Harmony still under the blanket when you arrived at Colonial Village?
Yes.
And that moaning that you mentioned, that weird noise that she was making, was she still making it?
No.
How long did that noise that she was making last?
I don't remember. It wasn't... I don't remember if it was too long. I don't remember if it was after we were at Colonial Village for a little bit. Or if it was before.
But that moaning, did it eventually stop?
Yes.
Did you check on Harmony at any point after the moaning stopped?
No.
Did Adam?
No.
Why didn't you check on her?
Because I was scared.
When you arrived at the Colonial Village parking lot, when you arrived back there, what did you and the defendant do?
We got drugs and got high.
When you say we got drugs and got high, what drugs did you get, Kayla?
Heroin and crack.
And how long did you use those drugs for in that parking lot?
We were there for probably 10 or 15 minutes.
Where did you go from the Colonial Village parking lot?
I don't remember where we were going, but I know we left.
You left at some point?
Yes.
And what happened when you left the parking lot?
We made it to the next street over, going towards Elm Street, and the car died when we got to the traffic light, and it wouldn't start or anything, and so we were stuck without a vehicle.
What was the defendant doing when the car died?
He was trying to get a jump, and there was no jumping the vehicle, and so we ended up having to leave it. And when we were getting out of the car and getting the kids out of the car, Harmony had passed away.
Let's talk about that. When you say Harmony had passed away, when did you realize that Harmony had passed away?
When Adam was trying to wake her up and she didn't reply or anything.
Was he saying things to her to try to wake her up?
Yeah, he said Harmony, and he kept saying baby girl, like, and trying to budge her, and there was nothing.
Was he touching her?
Yes.
What was he doing to her body at that point?
Trying to figure out what to do, and getting all the kids out of the car. He took the duffel bag that was in the trunk, and and put her in the duffel bag.
You mentioned this duffel bag from the trunk.
Yeah.
Had you seen that duffel bag before, Kayla? What was it used for?
When we got kicked out of the house, we put clothes in there for everybody. And it was in the trunk of the car.
Did you see him put Harmony in that duffel bag?
Yes.
How did he put her in there, Kayla?
He, like, folded her in half and put her in the duffel bag.
Did he call 911 at any point?
No.
Did you?
No.
And when you saw him put her in that duffel bag, did you attempt to get away to run?
No.
Why not?
Because they had the two other kids and I was scared.
Scared of?
That something would happen to me or Adam and the kids.
You said you saw him put her in that duffel bag, fold her up and put her in there.
Yes.
What did her face look like when you saw her go into that bag?
It was all black and blue, and her face was puffy, her eyes were puffy.
Did he say anything to you after he put her in that duffel bag?
I don't remember.
What did you do after he put her in the duffel bag?
We took the kids and we walked back to Colonial Village.
What did you do once you arrived at Colonial Village?
put the bag in the snowbank so Anthony wouldn't see it.
I'm sorry, so that who wouldn't see it, Kayla?
Anthony.
That's Anthony Badaro.
Yes.
Where was this snowbank that you put? And sorry, let me clarify. Who put her in a snowbank?
Adam.
Where was that snowbank that he put her in?
In the embankment from the parking lot.
What was around that snow embankment?
A dumpster. And cars and snow.
And you said he put it in there so that Anthony Badaro wouldn't see.
Yeah.
What did the defendant do after he put that duffel bag in the snowbank?
Left her there. And we got a ride from Badaro to get the stuff out of our car.
And where was your car at that point?
It was at that street. We ended up leaving it, and when we came to the car, it was already getting towed.
So Mr. Badaro gave you a ride back to your vehicle?
Yes.
Were you able to get belongings out of the vehicle?
Yes.
And who did that? Who got those items out?
Adam and myself.
That vehicle was your home at the time?
Yes.
What did you do after that in terms of a shelter?
Badaro let us sleep in his car for the weekend until I figured something out.
Just for the weekend?
Yeah.
Is that what you had asked him for, or is that what he said, just for the weekend?
That's what he said.
And what kind of vehicle did Mr. Badaro have?
An Audi.
Do you remember what color it was?
Blue.
Was it a car, a sedan, or an SUV?
A car.
And I want to talk about the time that you were living in that car that weekend. Where was Harmony's body at that point when you were living in Mr. Badaro's vehicle?
In the trunk of the car.
And did the defendant ever move it from the trunk of the car to another location?
Yes.
Where would he put it?
Near the dumpster.
Why?
So Anthony wouldn't see it.
Was it cold outside at the time?
Yes.
You mentioned snow. Was there snow on the ground?
Yes.
Did something happen to the vehicle that first night you were staying in Mr. Badaro's car?
Yes, the battery died.
What did the defendant do when the battery died?
Used somebody's phone and called Miss Frayne.
Is that Kimberly Frayne?
Yes.
Are you aware of him communicating with any other people regarding the dead car?
Not that I remember.
At that time, did the defendant have a Facebook account?
Yes.
Do you know if he had a Facebook account?
I don't remember. I don't remember.
But you recall a call to Miss Frayne?
Yes.
And what happened after that call?
She showed up with a battery pack jumper to jump the car.
Was she successful in jumping the car?
Yes.
And what were you doing while that was going on?
I was in the car with the kids.
Where was Miss Frayne?
Outside of the car with Adam.
I was going to ask, where was the defendant? Where was Harmony at that point when the car was being jumped?
In the trunk of the car.
What did you and the defendant do for food during your time in Mr. Badero's car?
Badero bought us pizza and brought it down to the car.
You mentioned being there for two nights.
Yes.
And the first night the battery died?
Yes.
When was the pizza given to you?
I think it was the next night. Because he did give us food for a couple of dinners. He gave us food. We had the pizza. And stuff like that.
Could you repeat that, please?
A couple of nights we got pizza.
And did you leave Mr. Badero's vehicle after that weekend?
Yes.
After those two nights you left?
Yes.
And can you tell the jurors where you went?
I went to my aunt's house.
And what's your aunt's name?
Kimberly Simmons.
Where did Miss Simmons live at the time?
In Manchester.
Was she on South Main Street?
Yes.
And how did you get to your aunt's home?
Bodero dropped us off.
Your Honor, may I approach?
Yes. Yes, you may.
So, Taylor, I'm going to hand you three exhibits, and I'm just going to ask that you look at the first one and look at what you need. So that first one, what's been marked as State's Exhibit 25 for identification, do you recognize what's depicted on that item?
Yes.
And can you tell the jurors what it is?
It's the apartment that my aunt lived in.
That again is on South Main Street.
Yes.
Is that a fair and accurate representation of your aunt's apartment?
Yes.
Your Honor, at this point I move to strike ID and mark as full. State's Exhibit 25.
Any objection?
No objection.
The ID is stricken. It's entered as a full exhibit.
Now, Kayla, when Mr. Badero dropped you, the defendant, and your two children off, where was Harmony's body?
In the duffel bag.
And who had that duffel bag?
Adam.
And what did he do with that duffel bag when you got to your aunt's house?
He placed it under the porch.
And you pointed at the exhibit just now. If you could just hold it up and show the jurors where you're pointing. Can you show me where you pointed? Taylor, if you can take a look at Exhibit 20, 26 and 27, what's been marked as ID for 26 and 27. What's depicted on those two items, Taylor?
The porch. Up close.
Is that a fair and accurate representation of your aunt's porch?
Yes.
Is there a difference in the two photos?
Yes. 27 has measuring tape, looks like.
And Your Honor, at this point, I move to strike the ID and mark as full State's Exhibit 26 and 27.
The ID is stricken. They're entered as full exhibits.
And I move to publish
them to the
jury. You mentioned the defendant put in, or
Harmony's body in that duffel bag under the porch?
Yes. Yes.
This is the porch that he put her under?
Yes.
Did he go into the home that day, into your aunt's home?
Yes.
How long were you there for, Kayla?
A few hours, because we were trying to figure out where to go.
What was the purpose of your trip to your aunt's home?
To talk, so that she could talk to my mother, so that she'll let us stay at her place.
What's your mother's name?
Christina Lubin.
So if I understand, you wanted your aunt to talk to your mother?
Yeah.
Did you end up seeing your mother that day?
Yes.
How did you come to see her that day?
She came to pick us all up, myself, Adam, and the kids, the two boys.
Where was Harmony at that point?
In a duffel bag.
And how did your mother pick you up? How did she arrive at your aunt's home?
She came in her van.
And what happened to that bag that Harmony was in when your mother came to pick you up?
We put it in the van.
And when you say we put it in the van, who put it in the van?
Adam.
How long did Harmony's body stay in the van?
Probably about five to 10 minutes.
Was it in there while you were traveling somewhere?
Yes.
Where were you going?
To my mother's place.
Did the defendant keep Harmony's body in the van?
For the drive, yes.
What did he do with Harmony's body when you arrived at your mother's home?
He took it out of the van and put it on the side near the trash at first until he figured out where to put her.
And what did he figure out in terms of where to put her?
There was a cooler in the hall walkway that the residents used to get in and out of the building, and it was on my mom's floor level in the hallway. And he put the cooler in, he put the duffel bag in the cooler.
And what was in the duffel bag at that point?
Harmony.
So he removed her from the trash and he put her in this cooler?
Yes.
Her body was still in the duffel bag at that point?
Yes.
May I approach her?
Yes, you may. Yes, you may.
So I'm showing you what's been marked as State's Exhibit 28 for identification.
Yes.
Do you recognize that item?
Yes.
What is it?
That is the cooler that was on the porch in my mom's hallway.
Is that a fair and accurate representation of the cooler?
Yes.
That's what it looked like?
Yes.
Your Honor, at this point I move to strike the ID and Marcus Cole, State's Exhibit 28.
No objection. The ID is stricken. It's entered as a full exhibit.
I move to publish.
Yes, you may.
Kayla, how did Harmony's body fit into this cooler?
Adam pushed it in the cooler so it would fit.
Is that something you saw him do?
Yes.
Were there any noises when he did that?
Not that I remember.
How long was she stored in that cooler for?
For 2 weeks.
And how long did you stay with your mother for? How long were you with Christina Lubin?
For 2 weeks.
Did her body stay in that cooler for the entire time You were with your mother?
Yes.
Why?
I honestly don't know.
How often did you see that cooler when you were living with your mother?
Every day, multiple times a day.
Where was the cooler kept?
In the hallway.
Was that your mother's hallway, or was it?
It was access to everybody who lived in the building, but it was on the level of my mom's apartment.
And tell us about that hallway. What else was kept there?
I don't remember.
Were there other items in that hallway?
I don't remember.
Where did you go after living with your mother?
To the FIT shelter, Families in Transition.
And when you moved to the Families in Transition shelter, is that FIT, the FIT shelter?
Yes.
When you moved to the FIT shelter, where was Harmony's body?
Adam put her... in the ceiling, in the vent of the room that we stayed in.
What room did he stay in while you lived in the Families in Transition shelter? The Families in Transition shelter, Kayla?
It was the first room. It was room one.
And how did he access the ceiling to store her in there?
He climbed, used the bunk bed and climbed up in the ceiling.
Was there something that allowed him to access the ceiling that was above that bunk bed?
There was a vent.
And who slept under that vent?
The kids.
Where did the defendant sleep?
We all slept on the floor on the mattresses.
So, Kayla, I'm showing you what's been previously marked for identification as States Exhibit 30. Through 34. Can you please look at each of these items in turn and describe what's depicted in them?
This is the outside of the family shelter.
And that states Exhibit 30.
And this is the door to room one, and next to it is the second room.
And that's Exhibit 30.
This is the room.
I'm just going to ask to move it a little away from the microphone. Thank you.
And when you say this is the room, whose room was that?
It was the room that we stayed in.
And that setup, the way the room is set up, is that similar to how it was when you lived there?
Yes.
And that states Exhibit 32. Let's go to States Exhibit 33. What is depicted there?
The vent above the bed.
And what happened with that vent?
Adam moved it so he could go in the ceiling.
Now, did you ever touch that vent, Kayla?
No.
And States Exhibit 34?
No, it's the vent.
Are those fair and accurate representations? Is that consistent with your memory of what those items looked like?
Yes.
Your Honor, at this point, I move to strike the ID and mark as full States Exhibit 30 through 34.
Any objection? Only through 34. All right, the ID is stricken. Those are entered as full exhibits and may be published to the jury.
And so, Kayla, I'm holding up what's been marked or what's been admitted as States Exhibit 30. What is this item? What is depicted here?
The outside of the family shelter.
How long did you live at this shelter for?
A month and a half, almost.
And States Exhibit 30? What's depicted in this image?
The room that was the one we stayed in was on the left side, room one, and the other room is the second one next to it.
So you stayed in room one?
Yes.
And you mentioned room two being beside
it. Yes.
And states exhibit 32 and 33. You mentioned that this was consistent with what the room looked like when you lived there?
Yes.
And those are the bunk beds that you mentioned?
Yes.
And you said you could see the vent that was used in these images?
Yes.
And can you remind the jury what's in State's Exhibit 34?
That's the vent that he climbed up to and put Harmony in the ceiling.
When you say he climbed up to put Harmony in the ceiling, who is he?
Adam.
At the time you were living at the Families in Transition shelter, was there anything going on with Harmony's body? Was she having any changes? Or was her body having any changes?
Yes.
And I want you to tell the jurors what those changes were.
You could smell a horrible smell that was coming through the vents.
Do you remember that horrible smell?
Yes.
Did maintenance come at some point while you were living there because of that smell?
Yes.
And what happened when those maintenance workers came?
Adam took her back down from out of the ceiling. And brought the bag in the bathroom.
And what happened when Adam brought Harmony down from the ceiling?
That she was starting to smell and there was fluid leaking.
So you smelled her, and did you see the fluid?
No, I didn't see it.
How do you know about the fluid that was leaking?
Adam said that.
What did he say?
He said that there was blood up in the ceiling and fluid.
And so what did he do with that duffel bag containing Harmony after he removed her from the ceiling because of maintenance?
He put her in a trash bag.
I'm showing you what's been marked as State's Exhibit 52 for identification.
Yes.
Kayla, do you recognize the item that's depicted in this image?
Yes.
What is that?
The CMC diaper bag.
Is that a fair and accurate representation of the CMC diaper bag?
Yes.
And how about State's Exhibit 53?
Yes.
Is that a fair and accurate representation?
Yes.
Of the item that's depicted?
Yes.
And what is that item?
It's the bag that Adam put Harmony in.
So you mentioned garbage bags that he put her in.
Yes.
What did he put those garbage bags into, if anything?
He put the garbage bags inside that bag.
So, Your Honor, at this point I move to strike ID, strike what's been marked as ID and mark as full, State's Exhibit 52 and 53.
An objection?
No objection.
And I move to publish,
52 and 53, the ID is stricken, they're entered as full exhibits and they may be published to the jury.
Thank you.
Harmony's body fit into this bag?
Adam's squished her in it.
I'm sorry, can you say that a little bit louder?
Adam squished her into the bag.
Okay, well, I'm showing you it's been marked for identification as State's Exhibit 85. Do you recognize this?
Yes.
Is this similar to that CMC bag?
Yes.
Is it in fact identical to that CMC bag?
Yes.
Your Honor, at this point I move to strike the ID of State's Exhibit 85 and mark as full and publish to the jury.
Any objection?
No objection.
The ID is stricken. It's entered as a full exhibit.
So the defendant put Harmony into garbage bags. And he squished her into a bag like this one?
Yes.
And this again was at the fundraising transition shelter?
Yes.
Where did he do that to her?
In the bathroom of the room that we stayed in.
Were you in the bathroom with him when he did that?
No.
Did you hear anything when he was doing that to her in the bathroom?
I heard a loud bang.
Could you see what was going on in there?
No.
You mentioned the defendant stuffing Harmony into the duffel bag.
Yes.
At that intersection in the car guide.
Yes.
And then you mentioned him squishing her into this bag.
Yes.
Did she fill that bag, that CMC bag that you just saw?
Yes.
Her body filled that bag?
Yes.
And what did he do with the bag after he put her in there?
He put her back in the ceiling.
You mentioned being at the Families in Transition shelter for a month and a half.
Yes.
During that time, did the defendant begin discussing disposing of Harmony, getting rid of her body?
No.
At some point, did he begin discussing disposing of Harmony, getting rid of her body?
Yes.
And what was his plan? What was his idea for getting rid of her?
To use lime. And dismember her.
What did he believe that lime would do if he used it on her body?
Speculation unless it's fixed.
The
objection is sustained. You can rephrase the question, please.
Did the defendant tell you what he believed lime would do if he used it on Harmony's body?
Yes.
What did he tell you?
That it will help decay her body.
That it would help decay her body?
Yes.
Did he tell you what he believed dismembering her would do?
No.
But he told you that that was his plan?
Yes.
Counsel, can you approach for just a minute? As I have said to you, we will take a mid-morning break. I think this is a good time to do that. I'm going to ask the witness for the moment, please remain on the stand. Ladies and gentlemen, I remind you, don't discuss the evidence that you've heard, this case with each other or with anybody else. Don't do any independent research. Don't look up anything on your phones. Make sure you're avoiding any headlines. And we will take a 15-minute break, so we'll come back and start testimony again in about five of. Okay? All rise for the jurors, please.